Today's action by the Federal Reserve, as we said earlier, is aimed at making it easier for businesses to borrow and then spend money. Our next story is about another effort to help business owners, in this case, low-income American entrepreneurs who are just getting started. Special correspondent Fred de Sam Lazaro reports on bringing an approach that has worked well in developing countries to the U.S. A version of this story aired on the PBS program Religion and Ethics News Weekly.
The billboards and signs in the Jackson Heights section of Queens, New York, reflect dozens of languages, cultures, and nationalities. It's an immigrant community of rich diversity, but also plenty of poverty. And there's a store for that, too, an American version of Bangladesh's famous Grameen Bank. No fancy lobby here. There aren't even enough chairs. But from this and five other cramped quarters in Queens and as far away as Oakland, California, Grameen America disburses dozens of micro-business loans each day, most for around $1,500, all of them to women, who studies show are more likely to repay loans and to spend money on their children's welfare.
Yes.
It is the brainchild of Nobel laureate Muhammad Yunus, whose Grameen Bank has helped millions of women entrepreneurs in his native Bangladesh. He wanted to test the concept in a developed country. With foundation grants and borrowing commercially under a federal community reinvestment law, Grameen America began in 2008 to wary customer reception, says CEO Stephen Vogel.
They were afraid that what we were offering, a low-cost loan, no collateral, no credit scores, no history necessarily of being in business, and we would give them a loan, they were afraid that there would be something that was going to come back in the end. It would be, we'll raise the interest rates, we would do something, but we didn't.
But word spread quickly, he says. Already many borrowers, like Maria Del Socorro, have paid off first and second Grameen loans. Del Socorro, a Colombia native who'd only had housekeeping jobs before, opened her decorations business. She's fulfilling a lifelong goal to turn her crafting skills into a business. Business is good and growing, she says.
It's good. I do all kinds of events, like birthdays, first communions, weddings. All the foam work you see is done by hand. I do all of this by hand.
She is among 11,000 women who've received loans from Grameen America, says Operations Chief Shah Nawaz.
When you were starting out in Bangladesh working for Grameen, did you ever dream that you'd be working with poor people in the United States of America?
No. It is the world biggest, richest country of the world. And the formula we develop, that is the poorest country of the world.
The United States is a country that everyone thinks has money, doesn't have any poor people. We have more than 45 million people living in poverty in the United States.
And he says it takes much more than financing to help them break out of it. Business counseling, keeping the books, paying bills, even opening savings accounts, which is required of borrowers. Even that is often not enough. Joe Salvaggio, a former Catholic priest who's worked for decades with poor people, says many would-be entrepreneurs fail because their finances are precarious.
The car got impounded, or they got sick, or the kids got sick, or the landlord. One time we gave a check to somebody and it ate up almost the whole $1,000 with bank overdraft charges.
Salvaggio runs Micro Grants, a Minnesota nonprofit that works alongside those who provide micro loans. But he says new entrepreneurs often need something more to get them over the hump, so he gives them grants of $1,000. Several microgrants clients are in Midtown Global Market, located in a long-shuttered Sears Roebuck store in a recovering Minneapolis neighborhood.
A lot of those places already had a $5,000 loan for inventory, but they don't want any more loans. They can't make the cash flow, so a $1,000 injection of cash is really helpful.
We use the money for, like, you know, to fix the store displays or like decorations for the store.
We use the microgrants dollars for, at the time, was to more signage.
I used it to purchase about 30 handmade Senegalese drums, which we use to offer free drum lessons every Sundays.
Salvador de Montesinos worked as a masseur and part-time cook to make ends meet. His $1,000 grant brought him closer to the goal of earning a living as an artist. He was able to buy a machine to make prints, which are much easier to sell than his very high-priced originals.
It's $140 and it's $70,000.
Tell me that again.
$140 and $70,000.
Someday he hopes to live off sales of originals.
So you've sold 3 originals so far?
Yes.
Over how many years?
In all my life.
Well, surprise, he sells about 10 times that number of the cheaper prints per year. One microgrants client who's closer to her lifelong goal is Shante Holmes. She opened a laundromat in Minneapolis's economically depressed North Side 2 years ago, a community she's deeply committed to.
I wanted a business that served a need, not a want. I didn't want to compete with the cell phone places. I didn't want to compete with the red hair and fake hair and all of that stuff. It's enough of that. I didn't want the bargain clothing or gym shoes.
Her business began with small loans, but the real source of stability and profit come from a 6-figure U.S. Army contract to service a Minnesota-based unit. Also help from Jamara Cheek, who's with a nonprofit that helps minority entrepreneurs.
She had no experience with government contracting. People are overwhelmed and daunted by government rules and regulations. And we literally held her hand and coached her through that process. It took 4 months after submitting an offer of her services to the government for her to hear back from them.
However, the huge volume of new business required a commercial truck she could not afford. The $1,000 down payment assistance from microgrants salvaged her major contract, she says.
It takes money to make money, so therefore it was like, well, I need some help to be able to get my bills at a zero balance. And Joe came in and made it easy for me.
For Joe Salvaggio, Holmes is a star client, a 41-year-old mother of 3 who was able to turn around an earlier life of chemical dependency and cancer. So far, Salvaggio has disbursed more than $2 million in $1,000 grants. He gets funds from foundations and many wealthy Minnesotans he got to know from his days as a priest.
These are entrepreneurs that have made money, you know, on their own, and they appreciate the, you know, principles of responsibility, accountability, production, getting, you know, business principles of delivering a quality product on time at a reasonable price.
Grameen America's CEO Vogel, himself a successful entrepreneur who also founded a private equity firm, says it's critical that small enterprises be nurtured among low-income Americans. It's not just the best bet for people in poverty, he says, it's often the only option.
They can't get a job. Jobs are very tight. Overtime is very tight. Many of our borrowers do have jobs. They have part-time jobs, and they're using these business opportunities to increase their income.
With its careful oversight and counseling, he says, Grameen America's loan repayment rate has been 99%+, far better than anything seen in big commercial banks.
Fred's reporting is a partnership with the Undertold Stories Project at St. Mary's University in Minnesota.